Welcome to a short how-to video about dual seal. The big question in this video is the dual seal pressure switch is activated and how to get the signal to the PLC. Our demo equipment to show you how to bring that alarm signal into the control room looks like this. We have three thermometers with a dual seal, but the pressure switch is not wired. Instead, I have a little switch here. And our control room, our PLC, is the mammograph. First option is the standard delivery, where you have the hard signal, which records the error signal and the error warning to the control room, and where the temperature still stays active. The pressure switch gets activated. What happens in the control room? The temperature signal still stays active, and on the hard status, we have an error. Okay, how is that wired actually, and how is the configuration? Looking inside that head, you see we have here the 4 to 20 milliamp loop, and here are the connections of the different sensors. Our transmitter is TMT82, the two-channel hard transmitter. Two-channel because on channel 1 we have the RTT, the temperature signal, wired. And on the second channel, we have that pressure switch. And the pressure switch is closed when all is fine. And when it's activated, it is like an open switch. And that means an error signal on the thermocouple. Let's have a look into the configuration of this. Here you see the setup of our TMT82 in field care. Key settings are sensor 1 is configured as an RTT PT100, like ordered for the sensor measurement. And sensor type 2 is configured to a type E thermocouple. Output is assigned to sensor 1 only, because the measured temperature should be output. Why do we use a thermocouple? Yeah, because the thermocouple has a valid signal as long as the switch is closed. And when I open that switch, we get an error signal. So the warning on the hard signal is our default delivery status. Second input is configured as a thermocouple. Benefits are 4 to 20 milliamp signal is not affected. We need only two wires to the transmitter, standard installation, but the PLC must support hard diagnosis. Option 2 shows an interruption of the 4 to 20 milliamp loop in case of an error. How is the wiring on that? Looking into the head, we got those two wires coming from the PLC, the 4 to 20 milliamp loop. We got that pressure switch in between, in that loop, and then going to the transmitter. And you see the pressure switch directly interrupts that 4 to 20 milliamp signal. In an overview, that looks like this. We have the transmitter, and in the hard loop, we got the interruption of that pressure switch. For sure, in the configuration, we have only one sensor configured. Sensor 2 is switched off. Benefit that we don't need the hard signal to be interpreted on the PLC, so no intelligent hard PLC required. The bad point about this is that we don't have a temperature signal anymore as soon as the pressure switch is activated. Next option requires four wires from the PLC and a digital input. So now we have the 4 to 20 milliamp loop directly going to the PLC, and two more wires going directly to the pressure switch. That means when the switch is activated, the digital input on the PLC gets that warning signal. Benefits in this case means that no hard signal needs to be detected on the PLC. We still have the temperature signal, 4 to 20 milliamp loop is not affected, but you need four wires to the transmitter. And then you have a digital signal on the PLC to evaluate the error.